sometimes, in certain times, you think to yourself, in certain situations, how did I get here? Like, and that's how I'm feeling right now. Because, like, how did someone like me, someone who's never joined an organization back in high school, someone who dreaded this meeting me at Pansy, like, year, like weeks ago, and like, how am I right here, right now, standing in front of an organization, giving a speech, running for a position in the EP? Well, I guess I can thank AJMA for changing everything. Like, this picture is represents who I was when I entered AJMA, because it was really out. I was really out of place, because like during song week, I remember I was the only one wearing red in my blockmates, because they were all part of AJMA. And in AJMA, I kind of settled on promos because I thought it would be the easiest job. Like, I would get the free 10 points of retention easily by just sharing stuff online. And little did I know that I was so off from that statement. And I remember having to sell tickets and having to go campus reach in Rohan as my force officer. And like, I really did not like interact with a lot of my post-software. Like, all I did was like did what whoever told me what to do. And honestly, I kinda enjoyed it either way, because it was working through promos where I kinda found direction and what I wanted to do with that. So AJMA was really the one that took me out of my comfort zone time and time again. I remember applying for different interviews just to reach their attention points. I remember having the worst ever interview for PRD with AHA. I remember filling up my summit application form, completing it probably like the day before, and then showing up to Comelec at the Binigan, seeing the president, the only person available for the interview. I immediately walked away because I was so intimidated. I saw that I was missing out on a lot of opportunities because of my fear, like, of speaking with people. And I told myself, if you want to succeed in this organization, you have to reach in, like, you have to count on yourself, like, you have to make sure that you improve. You have to make sure you start talking to people. And that's how what I did. Like, I started interacting with my post-op heads, top board, and my other heads. And like, it's really where I started to like AJMA even more, because like, I don't like AJMA because of its events. I like AJMA because of the fact that I was surrounded with so many talented people, and like, these people were the ones who kind of inspired me to do as hard as I can, to work as hard as I can, and it kind of made me want to emulate them. So second year, I decided to join as a force, to apply as a force officer. And like, I can say that I wanted to join as a force because I wanted to make sure that I have a bigger role in the organization, as well as prove to people that I'm capable of so much more. And during my time as force officer, I can say one thing, is that being assigned to marketing camp is probably the best thing that's ever happened to me in AJMA so far. And I think that being part of this org really made me care about AJMA so much more. Because like, days before the event, I remember being the only person working in the promos committee, and I had so many chances like to just leave, to not do whatever work that was assigned to me. But I really did not want to let the people who counted on me down, because they really trusted in me. And like, I knew that they believed in me and I was capable of doing the thing that they asked me to do. So after this experience, it kind of pushed me in and made me realize that I was capable. I wanted to do so much more and give much more to that. So this year I decided to apply as PRA. And what can I say? It's been like a very memorable and value-adding experience, because I have seen AJMA at its highs and its lows. I have seen Like, I have been fully immersed myself in this organization. I was able to, like, during the first time we met as an EVP, I did not know practically almost anyone. Like, I think it was just Marvel, we were in the corner. And so, like, if I look back now, like, so many friends that I've made in this organization. And because of this, like, working with the best and the worst kinds of people, like, it kind of made my experience in AJMA, like, so much more value. And this is why I want AJMA's future to be safeguarded. And so when I was coming to think of my platform,
please connect to the internet.
So when I was trying to come up with my platform, I was wondering, how can I help the org itself if I was in PR? Because all I thought, all this time, PR was all about safeguarding the image of AJMA. It was all about making sure that the org was seen in the right branding, consistent. And I thought that this wasn't really something that I agreed with, because I think it's time to change our mindset and perspective based on the times now. Because right now, like, our member development is really, we've kind of forgotten about it, because it was always projects first, members later, or even forgotten. So for my platform, like, I wanted to, my vision was, it was centered towards member development. So for the internal communications, I wanted to have, like, ideation meetings, which would like, create a foundation and develop a good working relationship with the communications department. Because, like, all my time in promos, like, there's always been some sort of problem with PR and com. Like, we've always been butting heads for some reason. And I also want to involve the promotions heads as well in the creative process, because they're not really giving their opinions on collaterals anymore. And this leads to improving the accountability. So we'll be also continuing the SDLP from last year. But I also want to evaluate like, the past year's promotions as well, because we'll be able to learn what went right, what went wrong, and go with that. And I also want to have clear and defined rule for promos for the heads. And for creating meaningful content, like, it's in our name. That's what we describe ourselves. We're the premier marketing organization. But if you look at our Facebook page, it's just events. There's nothing really, anything that's value adding in terms of marketing. And with this, I want to relaunch the website that was really supposed to be planned this year. And it would act as a main hub for, like, registration, for example, AIDS marketing camp. It would also have the past videos of the talks. And it can also serve as an archive for past events, as well as, for example, a Corel. A person is talking with a corporate sponsor, if they're interested, right, they're asking, what's this event about in depth in here? And then I also want to explore PR initiatives. So I want to recruit PR team, because they're not really doing anything outside the classroom. I want them to start interacting with people during MS training, or with people involving people outside the AJMA. Like, for instance, like, another recipient saying they're in the front of house. And I also want them to contribute content the website, and a beautiful thing of content resilience. This initiative is the creation of a space workshop. It's my goal for this is to have for AJMA to have an involvement in the LS community, and make sure that we develop and the passions of each person who attends. So why me? Like, people would go like, the people have, I know I have people who criticize my personality, like, I'm not really the type of person who likes talking to people, I'm not the best person at presenting things, I'm generally a shy person who, like, prefers to work behind the scenes, but I can tell you now that as my time in AJMA, I've grown so much, and I have seen how AJMA has changed, and how the people inside AJMA has changed. So I'm standing here right before all of you right now with my experience and passion for AJMA, and with my platform and vision. let's pursue possibilities together. Because
Fernando, not imperfect.